the same place. Here, only one thing has changed. Time. 7 centuries ago, the homes in Cliff Dweller Canyon were aglow from fires that burned into the night. Small children played and families laughed together. Over the coals of long nurtured fires, the smells of cooking food drifted on a gentle evening breeze. Here in the midst of the Gila wilderness, on the edge of a mountain frontier, was a small village of stone. Here in Cliff Dweller Canyon, the Mogollon people would leave their mark. The stone walls are just the visible legacy of an ancient culture that intrigues archaeologists today. But just who were the Mogollon? What happened here centuries ago? As it turns out, we know where the Mogollon came from. They were here all along. The Mogollon were not recent arrivals from Mexico or from anywhere else. Their ancestors were the Indian peoples of the Southwest, who archaeologists believe were here for at least 10,000 years. The archaic Indian peoples lived close to the land, and they left little more than stone tools and footsteps behind them in the archaeological record. It was the archaic people who first occupied the caves here at Gila Cliff Dwellings. These people had baskets, but they did not have ceramics or pottery of any kind. They were hunters and gatherers living off the land. On occasion, they sought shelter in these caves, and though centuries of their campfires blackened the cave ceilings, the caves were only temporary homes for these nomadic people. Writings on stone are a record of their presence. From these vague beginnings, a distinct culture were to emerge, the Mogollon, about 2,000 years ago. By the year 200 AD, the Mogollon were constructing pit houses, homes built partially underground. They made pottery. It was plain, simple, and utilitarian, brown or red. From the desert-dwelling Hohokam to the west, they acquired shells. In later years, they traded pottery for turquoise with the ancient Pueblos, and they regularly traded with the peoples to the south of Mexico. Archaeologists have found macaw feathers at Gila Cliff Dwellings. Ancient images in stone tell us that this valued bird was transported live from tropical Mexico, probably in cages. Mogollon homes were originally villages of pit houses located on mesa tops and ridges where the people banded together, possibly for defense. Eventually, they moved to the valley floors to be closer to their crops of corn. Their pit houses changed from round to rectangular rooms. In time, their homes would be built entirely above ground. By the year 900 AD, populations increased and the Mogollon expanded their territory. In the next 400 years, the glow of lights and the warmth of fires would spread across the southwest and would break the grip of darkness. The Mogollon began to develop their classic Mimbres pottery, combining animal forms and unique geometric patterns and designs. The Mimbres branch of the Mogollon centered around the Mimbres River to the east. Though they lived close to the caves, they would not be the ones to construct the homes at Gila Cliff Dwellings. The architects were immigrants. They were Mogollon, but they came here in a cross-country trek from the Tularosa area about 75 miles northwest of the Gila Cliff Dwellings. They migrated across the Mogollon Mountains and brought with them their own distinct pottery style. Why did these people come here? They may have been driven out of their homeland. In this harsh land of undependable rainfall, water has always been the source of survival. Overpopulation combined with a devastating 24-year-long drought from 1276 to 1299 forced the abandonment of villages and Pueblo towns across the southwest. The Gila River was an oasis in this time of drought, and it may have been a refuge. Evidence points to warfare in the southwest, perhaps as a result of dwindling food supplies. It was in this great period of drought and strife that the Gila cliff dwellings were constructed and occupied. The builders began the trek from their homeland, probably in the early 1270s. They found what we see today, a series of seven caves carved by the forces of erosion over many thousands of years. Here, they found a home. They lived in the first five caves and entered cave six, using it temporarily, though they never built it. The Gila cliff dwellings are unusual. Seldom did the Mogollon people seek shelter in the caves. The almost inaccessible reaches of Cave 7 made it impractical for the cliff dwellers to occupy, and no evidence has been found of its use. In many respects, Gila cliff dwellings is an ideal location. The caves open southward and take advantage of solar heat. During the winter months, with the sun lower on the horizon, sunlight penetrates the cave openings, warming the rooms. In the summer, with the sun high in the sky, the caves remain relatively cool and shaded. To survive, the cliff dwellers hunted and grew corn, squash, and beans nurtured by waters from the Gila River and the side streams like Cliff Dweller Creek. In 1884, the first archaeologist to explore the region, Adolf Bandelier, reported the remains of an irrigation ditch at the mouth of Cliff Dweller Creek and one near Gila Hot Springs. Though the dwellings had been discovered just a few years earlier by cattlemen, they were heavily vandalized by the time Bandelier arrived. He wrote in his journal, "Very little pottery. Visitors having picked it up, the place, as it is now rifled." Bandelier and other early explorers reported that, except in a few places, the walls never reached the ceiling of the caves. They stopped about 20 inches from the ceiling to allow smoke to escape the confines of the caves. Some walled enclosures were never roofed. They were open work areas, like Pueblo courtyards. The ravages of time and the ravages of humans have taken their toll on villages in the southwest. Vandals and pottingers have destroyed much. Today, the 42 rooms of Gila cliff dwellings represent a snapshot of time, a brief period in the life of the cliff dwellers. Virtually all building took place between the years 1270 and 1290. The caves were home to 40 to 60 people. Very little remains of Cave 1, just foundations. It was probably home to one family. From evidence gathered by archaeologists, Cave 2 may have been the first cave to have cliff dwellings constructed within it. Almost all timber for construction was cut between 1274 and 1287. With no glass or large sheets of mica, they did not have windows, only doorways, and small openings. In Cave 2, four openings face the canyon. Interestingly, Cave 2 has a T-shaped doorway, which is typical of ancient Pueblo peoples, not the late Mogollon. The ancient Pueblones, the builders of cliff dwellings and cities of stone. Certainly the Mogollon of this period had traded not only goods, but ideas. Cave 3 is the largest single cave. It is split into two separate levels because of its sloping floor. Most of the cave was a flat open area and was never divided into separate rooms or work areas. Cave 3 was also the most desirable cave in the winter. Its roof arches upward and would trap the warm air from hearts. The two largest roof rooms in Gila cliff dwellings are the ceremonial chairs. Evidence of plastering, painting, wall niches, and mural art has been found in ceremonial rooms. These rooms received the most care in construction and attention to detail. In Cave 4, a complete two-level building stands by itself. It is in much the same condition as when it was used by the cliff dwellers. Cave 5 has a large room that occupies